The countdown is on for one of the biggest consumer electronics shows of the year. Hello everyone, I'm Diana Blass with CRN TV, and come Sunday you can find me and my colleagues Kyle Alsbach and Lindsay O'Donnell in Vegas for CES. Here's what we can expect. Lots of news on Google. The tech giant will have a big presence at CES as it continues its push to take on Amazon's Echo connected speaker. Apple will also be on the trade show floor showing off its Apple HomeKit. The HomeKit uses a Siri personal assistant to operate smart homes through apps on iPhone, iPad, and Apple Watch. But efforts like HomeKit can only succeed if lots of major companies support the technology. The more useful it becomes, the more consumers will buy in. Apple's moves show it's aiming to become part of a larger ecosystem. In other news, we're expecting the computer manufacturing company Lenovo to have a major presence at CES. Already, Lenovo has announced major revamps to three major lines of its ThinkPad portfolio. And also expect to hear about Huawei. The vendor is one of the largest telecommunications equipment makers in the world and sits just behind Samsung and Apple in global smartphone market share. We're hearing it could land a partnership with AT&T and possibly Verizon. Those announcements could be made at CES. And speaking of smartphones, CES could be featuring some bigger smartphone releases than usual. The Samsung Galaxy S9 and the LG G7 are rumored to be teased, if not unveiled, and Samsung could reveal a new foldable phone called the Galaxy X. Other subjects we're keeping our eyes on, news on autonomous cars and the rise of 5G, the next generation of wireless networks which we're hearing could begin rolling out over the next couple of years. So clearly lots to see and talk about. Be sure to stay with CRN.com for the latest. I'm Diana Blass with CRN TV.